So I've talked a lot about composable commerce, and composable commerce is the ability to basically build your e-commerce platform from best of breed suppliers. As a business, it gives you the flexibility and the agility to build your platform from the capabilities that you actually need. Sounds really great for me, but how does it actually work in reality? How do you basically get components or services from lots of different suppliers and then compose them, join them together into one single platform? It's a really important question to think about. And I know that there are many of you thinking about this question right now. But for now, let's waste no more time. Let's get to it. In my previous videos, I used the concept of the Gartner Cube to represent what composable commerce is. In the cube, the x-axis represents the package business components, or PBCs, that actually represent the capabilities of the platform. Capabilities such as the PIM, CMS, search, core commerce, order management, those kinds of things. And the y-axis is used to represent the tech stack, such as MACH architecture. Ultimately, think of the BPCs as the components that you're going to compose your e-commerce platform from. Think of the tech stack as how those components are built, and also they may reflect how you may integrate them together. And finally, the actual customer journey is where the components will be used. In the original articulation, most of the focus was placed in the UX layer because this is what the users see and this is what the users interact with. And we see this with things like presentation orchestration layers, DXPs, front-end as a service providers, PWAs and storefronts, and even supporting technologies like BFF and GraphQL. So in many people's minds right now, composition could be seen as simply plugging in PBCs into a UX layer. Thinking of composable commerce as just a simple plug and play, just put your BPCs into your UX, into your user experience, is to me somewhat naive and very simplistic. It doesn't really capture the complexities of an e-commerce business. And yes, if all e-commerce was doing was basically aggregating data and content and representing it at the front end, then actually this concept, this way of doing the composition would be more than sufficient. But basically, it is not that simple. First of all, the orchestration of microservices is not limited to just outputting your experience. It also has to deal with user inputs, such as adding to your basket, dealing with orders, managing your account, dealing with returns, or even dealing with support issues. So let me explain further. Just a customer making an order could call many different BPCs. It could call the order management system. It could call the inventory system, the fulfillment system, core e-commerce, and even customer notification services. All of these microservices calls across all of these PBCs need to be orchestrated. And getting this right is just as important to the customer experience as actually representing the UI, because if your order doesn't go through correctly, or if it's inaccurate, that is a disaster. And in fact, many of these calls will be asynchronous and won't even show up in the UX. They'll show up in other channels such as email. On top of this, the distributed nature of microservices makes it incredibly difficult to create what we would call atomic, consistent, isolated, and durable transactions, or ACID transactions, which were actually very easy to create in a monolith situation. And what you need to do is employ other architectural patterns in the mid-tier and at the back end to facilitate this. And I might cover these in further videos in the future. But for this conversation, it's important to understand that composing platforms from PBCs is more than just the UX layer. You also have to consider the back end and the communications to all the back end services when you're doing the composition. Another big consideration is that of data, because every package business component will have its own separate data source. In the Gartner report, they recommended using systems of record to actually synchronize these systems. And this architectural pattern was actually quite popular in the last decade, and we've seen a whole host of master data management systems residing deep within an enterprise. The problem using these old MDM solutions is that it suffers from synchronization and relevancy problems. It doesn't make sense, for instance, to take huge data feeds of products and push them into different systems, because as soon as a data feed is pushed into a system, it's actually out of date. And plus, you're dealing with all the problems of duplication of data. And what we're seeing in the MACH architectural world are systems of record playing a direct role in the customer experience, such as PIM providers like Akeneo and DAM and CMS providers like Ampliance. The connection of data across PBCs in a MACH world is done through referencing IDs and APIs. PBCs keep themselves informed of relevant data changes in other PBCs using things like webhooks and event-driven architectures. Again, when you are thinking about composable commerce, it's not just the UX. You also need to think about the data and how you connect data and compose data across different PBCs. So far, most of the considerations we've been through for building composable commerce have really centered on the customer experience and interacting with the customer experience. But many people forget that actually e-commerce is a business. And as such, we also need to consider the experience of the business users. The advantage of the monolithic suite was that it would bring together all of the business processes into a consolidated business console. When you go down a composable route, you get best of breed technologies and best of breed capabilities, but each one of these PBCs delivers a different business console. The BPC consoles may have completely different experiences, use different terminologies, and maybe even take different approaches. Many business processes may span across multiple PBCs. Consider things like range in a product. Another way of thinking about this is another experience layer, a business experience layer that the PBCs plug into in the same way that they plug into the customer experience layer. And this is one of the least thought through areas when it comes to composable commerce, but it's still a really important one. In conclusion, composable commerce is an extremely powerful approach for building modern day commerce platforms. But the promise of low-code and no-code solutions is still a bit far off, and in fact, still requires coding or special tools for orchestration, or even both. Most of the tools for composition focus on the front end and are still web store centric. And don't get me wrong, these can be really powerful, but don't be fooled into thinking that they're gonna solve all of your problems. The things you need to think about are, how are you going to orchestrate your PBC services to manage transactions and user interactions? You need to consider how your data flows and connects. You need to consider how your PBCs are going to talk to each other. And finally, you need to consider your business user experience and how you're going to operate a platform built from multiple and different PBCs. And if you found this video useful, you may also find this other video useful I did on composable and MACH architecture. But for now, it's time to say thank you, goodbye, and I'll see you next time.